She's here on behalf. For the goddess.
The anointing has shown us the goddess.
How kind of you to spend a moment with me before you depart. There can be no doubt now. You are a blessing made flesh, the will of the goddess incarnate.
It's really not that simple, Tirsa. But I guess it's close enough.
I know the path ahead will be dangerous. To kill a metal devil sounds impossible, but I believe in you.
Thank you. The Nora have suffered terrible losses, Tirsa. What's to become of them now?
That will be for the goddess to decide. Only she knows the future. For the moment, my sister matriarchs and I will see to the wounded. And as I promised, anyone who wishes to join you at Meridian, we will declare seekers. I think for the time being, we should remain here in the mountain, close to the goddess.
That might be best. If nothing else, it's a defensible position. Tirsa, I want to know Rost's story. Why he was made an outcast. He never told me, said he took an oath of silence. What did he do?
Oh. Yes, that.
What crime did he commit?
I will tell you if you wish. But it is a long story. Are you sure you want to hear it now?
Of course I want to hear it. Tell me.
Rost never committed any crime. He was an outcast by choice.
What? What do you mean?
Many years ago, before the derangement, before the Red Raids, a band of murderous outlanders, 12 in number, struck without warning. At Mother's Vigil, they took hostages, and then pressed on, headed for Devil's Thirst.
Mother's Vigil? Where's that?
You would know it as the Forsaken Village, near the Karja border. But at the time, many families lived there. Rost's was one of them. His mate was killed fighting the Outlanders, and his daughter was among those taken hostage.
His daughter? What was her name?
Alana. She was just 6 years old.
Nora Braves couldn't stop 12 Outlanders? Or rescue the hostages?
It was quite impossible. We outnumbered them. But every time a Brave came within bowshot, the Outlanders killed a hostage.
What did they come here to do?
That was never discovered. We couldn't track closely enough to observe them. We know they camped beyond Devil's Thirst for 2 days. There were reports of strange noises. And then, as suddenly as they came, the Outlanders made their way back to the border, and disappeared.
What happened to Rost's daughter? She was killed?
Rost was one of the Braves who tracked the Outlanders, keeping his distance. There were 6 hostages still alive when they reached the border, Alana among them. Rather than release them, the Outlanders slit their throats and left the corpses just across the border, mocking us.
Why?
Cruelty. They knew the faithful Nora would not leave the sacred land to collect the bodies, let alone pursue them. They thought themselves safe from our vengeance.
Are you saying that Rost went after them? That he became an exile?
No. Rost was beside himself with grief, but even so, he would never have broken taboo.
Then what did he do?
He called upon the most terrible and secret rite of the Nora tribe. He begged to be made a Death Seeker.
A Death Seeker? What is that?
one who dies to go seeking, and in seeking, brings death to others. The ritual drags the spirit from one's body, releasing it to all mother's care. The heart beats, the mind thinks, but the spirit has moved on.
I don't understand.
Rost went after the Outlanders, but his spirit never left. It remained here with All Mother. He gathered the bodies of the slain and returned them. And then he set out in pursuit, not as an exile, but a weapon of vengeance. A barbed arrow shot from a bow, never to return.
But Rost did return.
Yes. A full year later, and terribly wounded. He collapsed at the border of the Sacred Land. A hunting party came upon him. He was delirious, in agony. By law, he should have died where he lay. But one of the hunters broke taboo, and reaching across the border, she dragged him to our side.
Who was she?
A brave who'd lost a mate and two sons to the very Outlanders that Rost pursued.
So Rost never finished his mission?
To the contrary, he killed all 12. Tracked them to disparate places the world over, he said. Meridian, Ban-Ur, the Claim, Utaruland, further even, into the Forbidden West. The last he killed nearly got the best of him. Wounded, he stumbled and crawled back to us, hoping to die as close to the Sacred Land as he could. He never expected nor asked to be dragged across the border and nursed back to health. That was done to him. Leaving us, the matriarchs, in a difficult position.
Why couldn't you just welcome him back?
Rost had been made a Death Seeker, Aloy. He no longer had any place among the tribe. By law, he should have been driven back out. But we couldn't bring ourselves to do that, so we offered a compromise.
You made him an outcast?
Yes. We offered to do so on the condition he never speak to anyone of this exception.
After all he did, all he suffered, to be declared an outcast was his reward.
Rost was overjoyed. He never expected to live another day in the Sacred Land, let alone the embrace so close to the goddess. He resolved to spend the rest of his days in solitude, and was happy to do so.
But then you found me, and gave me to him.
Yes. Another compromise. The matriarchs feared you, and would not let you be raised by the tribe. And so we turned to Rost. I knew that he would take care of you, bring you up, teach you to worship All Mother and respect the ways of the tribe.
He certainly tried anyway. You took a man who'd lost his daughter and made him raise an infant girl? Doesn't that strike you as callous?
I'm inclined to think the course of events has shown the wisdom of our choice. And I'm quite certain that from the moment he laid eyes on you, he saw you as a gift and never a burden.
All right, Tirsa, that's quite a story. It's time for me to move on. I thank you for doing what you could to help me through the years, and for telling me Rost's story.
I wish I could have done more, but I am just one woman.
As am I. No need to sell ourselves short.
Oh, thank you, Aloy. I will pray for you.
Okay, I guess it can't hurt.
Protect her so she can cleanse the corruption that still infects the land.
My life has been long, But I've never seen anything like that. Tirsa was right. A blessing, not a curse. We were so unsure.
I am humbled to be in your
presence. You honor me.
In all my years, I have never seen anything like that.
I shouldn't stare. She's going to think I'm rude. So much corruption still.
I will lead a war party to
Aloy! How did you do that?
Shush, Alana. She's the anointed.
We'll go to Meridian, Aloy. I'll bring Mother's spear.
Arana.
Your father is right. You belong here. You both do.
Thank you, Aloy, for everything you've done. I will make sure Arana is kept safe.
Dad, I'm not a kid anymore.
Aloy.
Aloy.
Aloy. Aloy. I don't know what to say.
Say that you'll see me at Meridian.
Of course. That much is simple. But the rest...
complicated. I know. But maybe if I took you into the heart of the mountain...
No. At least... not yet. I don't know. Please don't think less of me, Aloy. But the goddess chose you to see that. Not me.
Right. I'll be on my way then.
I always knew you weren't like other Nora.
Neither are you, Varl. Maybe if we survive all this, I can show you what I've learned. What I'm learning.
Perhaps. If the goddess so wills it.
See you in Meridian.
Our fallen tribespeople call out for justice.
The tribe I served is gone. Soon I will be too.
The Nora have lost too many, Resh. But in your case, I guess they can lose one more.
Curse the goddess, and curse you. I no longer belong here.
I think you're onto something, Resh. Time to strike out on your own. Ouch.
Thank you. time to think of it. What you need.
Yes, you look capable. You might do. Come here, if you will.
Smoke.
Let's have a chat. No, a colorful discussion.
Just to look at price.
What reason do Oseron need for anything?
But it's growing on me.
Ah, you're back. Did you bring me something lovely? Ah, let us haggle over this beautiful bounty. Till we meet again, my noble Nora. A moment of your time, Outlander?
Oseron guard.
Find better wares.
Could you spare a moment to speak of the finer things?
We're letting the Oseram decide.
Back from the wilds. Find any Banuk relics? You ready? Let's trade then. Come on back if you find any Banuk goods.
I'd like to discuss a trade with you, Outlander.
To kill the Sun King doesn't...
Would you like to buy something today?
The Sun King...
Thank you.
here, just like the people.
Eventually.